Hi, today we are going to learn about brachial plexus. Brachial plexus is a very important topic when you are learning about the anatomy of the upper limb, because brachial plexus is going to innervate the upper limb. The word brachium means arm, and plexus means it is basically a network of nerves. So you imagine a nerve like this, another nerve joins like this, and it branches off. So it creates a network-like structure, and that is why it is called as a plexus. And though it is quite complex, if you learn the anatomy of the brachial plexus, then the innervation of the arm is going to be easy. Brachial plexus we will learn under different headings of different parts of the brachial plexus. It begins with the roots, then the trunks, then the divisions, then the cords, and then the branches. Here I'm going to draw the right brachial plexus. Okay, so the brachial plexus begins from this side and then descends down like this. Okay. So the roots are basically the primary anterior rami, or the primary ventral rami of C5, C6, C7, C8, and T1. So let me write those numbers here: C5, C6, C7, C8, and T1. This is the most common pattern of brachial plexus in 80% of cases. The roots are basically the primary ventral rami of C5, so to C8 and T1, spinal nerves, primary ventral rami. Now what happens is the C5 and C6 together forms the upper trunk. Okay, C5 and C6 will combine together to form the upper trunk. The C7 will remain as such, and the C8 and T1 also joins to form the lower trunk. So these are known as the upper, the middle, and the lower trunk. Now what happens is the upper, middle, and the lower trunk, all these three trunks is going to divide into an anterior and a posterior division. Okay, so the anterior divisions I will use the same color, the orange color itself. So this is the anterior division. This is the anterior division of the middle trunk. Okay, as you can see, the middle trunk anterior division is somewhat converging towards the anterior division of the upper trunk. Okay. And this is the anterior division of the lower trunk. So each of these are going to give anterior divisions. I'm going to draw posterior divisions. Posterior divisions will be obviously going more posteriorly. The posterior divisions I'll use a different color. This is a green colored posterior division. As you can see, posterior division is going behind it. Okay, behind it. That is a posterior division. The middle trunk also gives off a posterior division. The lower trunk also gives off a posterior division. Okay, it's good to note that all the posterior divisions are together forming, are joining together to form a cord. But the anterior divisions of the upper trunk and the middle trunk is together forming another cord. Okay. And the anterior division of the lower trunk is forming another cord. Okay, here the point that you need to know is that this structure, the green structure, is more posterior. This is more lateral. And this is more medial because, as I said before, this is of the right side. I'll try to illustrate this by putting the axillary artery over here. Axillary artery, I'll use a red color, and I'll just demonstrate the axillary artery somewhat like this. Okay, this is a section of the axillary artery. So if this is the axillary artery, you need to know that this is the lateral cord. The lateral cord is somewhat above and lateral to the axillary artery. This is the medial cord. It is more medial, but this one that you see as the posterior cord, the green one, is more posterior to the axillary artery. So if this is the axillary artery, then laterally you have the lateral cord, posteriorly you have the posterior cord, and medially you have the medial cord. You are looking at the right side brachial plexus. So that is the reason why you have these names. So let me review till now. There are five roots, C5, C6, C7, C8 and T1. There are three trunks, upper, middle and lower trunk. Each of these trunks is going to divide into divisions. The anterior divisions or the ventral divisions are the one that I have put as orange. So there are three ventral divisions and three dorsal divisions. So there are total number of six divisions. I'll just write these numbers. Five roots, three trunks and six divisions. Of these six divisions, two of them are joining together to form the lateral cord. All the three posterior cords are posterior divisions are joining together to form the posterior cord, and the anterior division of the lower trunk is continuing as the medial cord. So there are total number three cords. Please note these numbers: five roots, three trunks, six divisions, and again three cords. So finally, there are three cords, and these three cords are very important. And from these three cords, you have the main branches from the cords. These branches can be learned with mnemonics. So I'll first draw the branches and then I'll use the mnemonic to make it easier for remembering. From the lateral cord, you have a lateral pectoral nerve, a musculocutaneous nerve, and the lateral root of the median nerve. Okay. So I'll write this down. This is musculocutaneous. This is lateral pectoral nerve. And this is the lateral root. Of the median nerve. These three I can remember with a mnemonic. This is a memory aid. LML. Lateral pectoral nerve, musculocutaneous nerve, and lateral root of median nerve. Now, let us look at the posterior cord. The posterior cord is going to give off two main terminal branches. One is the very important radial nerve, and the next is the axillary nerve. Other than these, there are smaller branches. You have upper and lower subscapular and a thoracodorsal nerve. Okay, this is thoracodorsal. These are upper and lower subscapular nerves. The upper and lower subscapular nerves are going to supply the subscapularis muscle. Thoracodorsal is going to supply the latissimus dorsi muscle. Okay, this is the radial nerve and this is the axillary nerve. I can remember these five nerves: upper, lower subscapular, thoracodorsal, radial and axillary, using a mnemonic, ULTRA, ULTRA. ULTRA is a mnemonic that I can use to remember the branches of the posterior cord. Next, you can see the medial cord. The medial cord gives off a medial pectoral nerve. As we saw, there was a lateral pectoral nerve here. So this is the medial pectoral. I'm drawing this like squiggly in this direction because I'm trying to convey that this is coming anterior. Okay, it's coming more anteriorly. So that is the medial pectoral nerve. You have a medial cutaneous nerve of arm and a medial cutaneous nerve of forearm. And then you have an ulnar nerve. It is a very important nerve going towards the hand. Okay, to the arm, to the forearm and to the hand. And then you have the medial root of the median nerve. Before, we saw the lateral root of the median nerve. So the lateral root of the median nerve and the medial root of the median nerve is going to join together to form the median nerve. Okay, this is called the median nerve. This is the ulnar nerve. This is the medial pectoral nerve. And these two are the medial cutaneous nerve of the arm. Medial cutaneous nerve of the arm and forearm. This is the medial root of the median nerve. Let me just highlight with this white ink. Let me just highlight the most important nerves that you are going to learn in the upper limb. One is musculocutaneous nerve. It's a very important nerve in for the arm compartment. Then the median nerve, the radial nerve, and the ulnar nerve are the major three nerves reaching till the hand. Okay. Then you have the axillary nerve, which is important for the shoulder. Okay. So these are the five most important nerves that you need to know throughout in your upper limb. The musculocutaneous, the axillary nerve, and till the end of the hand, till the distal extremity of the hand, you have the median nerve, you have the median nerve, the radial nerve, and the ulnar nerve. Okay, now these are the, I know that there are so many nerves that you learned here. I forgot to tell a mnemonic for the medial cord. The medial cord branches, you can learn with the mnemonic 4MU, 4MU, because there are 4 M's and there is a U. What are the 4 M's? There is a medial pectoral nerve, 1 M, medial root of median nerve, 2, medial cutaneous nerve of arm and medial cutaneous nerve of forearm. That is 4 M's, 1, 2, 3, and 4, and then you have an ulnar nerve. So that is the mnemonic for the medial cord branches. Okay. So we learned 3 mnemonics. One is 4MU for the medial cord, ultra for the posterior cord, and LML for the lateral cord branches. A couple of more branches that you need to know. From the upper trunk, that we saw here, upper trunk, you have a suprascapular nerve and a nerve to subclavius. So if you look at this point, you can see 6 nerves are converging. The C5 and the C6 roots, the suprascapular nerve and the nerve to subclavius. Okay, and it's the anterior and the posterior divisions. So 6 nerves are converging at this point, and this point is known by the name Erb's point. Erb's point. Erb's point is nothing but actually the upper trunk. Okay. An injury to this region, the upper trunk, can cause an Erb's palsy. So this point is called the Erb's point in the brachial plexus. There is another Erb's point that is learned in cardiac auscultation. Next, you have a nerve coming from the C5 root. Okay, that is called the dorsal scapula. This is the dorsal scapular nerve, dorsal scapular nerve, also called the nerve to the rhomboids. Next, you have a nerve that arises from C5, C6, and C7. So I'll use contributions from C7, C6, and C5. Okay. This nerve is a very important nerve. This is called as the long thoracic nerve, long thoracic nerve, or the nerve of Bell, nerve of Bell. This is the nerve that will supply the serratus anterior. This is also called as the nerve to serratus anterior. All right, we learned a lot of details, a lot of branches, but please understand the main subdivisions of the brachial plexus: the roots, the trunks, the divisions, the cords, and the branches, final branches. Branches, we can use 3 mnemonics: LML for lateral cord, ultra for the posterior cord, and 4MU for the medial cord. This is the suprascapular and the nerve to subclavius, coming from the Erb's point or the upper trunk, dorsal scapula from the C5, and nerve to the serratus anterior or the long thoracic nerve or the nerve of Bell from C5, C6, and C7. This is the brachial plexus schematic diagram. Thank you.